In this video, we send Office 365 log data to Splunk. Hello everyone, I'm Travis and this is Seraldos. In this video, we're going to install and configure the Splunk add-on for Microsoft Office 365 to collect log data, then install another add-on to visualize that data. Before we get started, please take a second to subscribe, click the like button, and click the bell icon to get notifications of new content. This helps my channel a lot and it's 100% painless. Also, follow me on Twitter if you're so inclined. Microsoft has a lot of native options for reviewing and alerting on log data in Azure and O365. There's the Azure Security Center, Azure Sentinel, Log Analytics, and Insight. This is all fine for an Azure-centric organization, but many organizations already have a logging platform in place and may want to send O365 data to that instead of splitting the log data between two applications. In this video, we're going to configure Splunk to collect log data from Azure AD and O365. I'm going to demonstrate Azure activity and login data. I'll also show you how to collect logs from other services such as Teams, Exchange, and SharePoint. I have to admit, my Splunk skills are not that great. The goal of this video is getting data into Splunk. What you do with it once it's there is up to you. However, I will install an add-on at the end of the video that provides a dashboard view of that data. I'm starting out with a fresh install of Splunk and an Azure AD tenant. This is a test tenant and the data will be kind of limited, but it will get what we need for this video. We're going to start by adding the application to Azure AD. An Azure AD application is not what you would traditionally consider an application. It's the representation of an application that uses Azure AD. It's kind of like a service account in Windows. I'm oversimplifying it a little bit, but you get the point. The application needs access to the Office 365 Management API to read log data. We'll set that up after the application is created. The next step is to gather the client ID, the application ID, and give the application a password. This is needed for the Splunk add-on to authenticate to Azure AD to pull the logs. Once that's finished, we go over to Splunk and add the add-on for Microsoft Office 365 and configure the tenant and log collection in that add-on. After that, we wrap up by adding the Microsoft 365 app to Splunk to visualize the data. One more thing quick before we move on. Towards the end, I show the dashboard the add-on creates for my test tenant. There isn't a lot of data displayed because there's just not a lot of data in that tenant. If you have some impressive data after setting up logging to Splunk, I would love to see what it looks like. If you can share, tweet an image and tag me so I can see it. Let's get started in the Azure portal to set up the application. Okay, everyone, let's get started. I am in Splunk and this is a brand new install. I downloaded and installed the trial version. I think it's the free version, or I think I get enterprise for a few days and then it switches to free. Anyway, the first thing I'm going to do is go to apps and find more apps. And I'm going to search for Microsoft Office 365. So this Splunk add-on for Microsoft Office 365, that's what we want. I'll click install and it's going to have me enter in my username and password. So it's going to install the add-on. This will take a couple minutes. Okay, it's asking for a restart, so I'll restart it now and wait for this to come back. It's back, I'll log in again. Now you can see a Splunk add-on for Microsoft Office 365 is showing as an app. And there's nothing in here. So the first thing we have to do is configure it, and if we go to tenant, we need to add our Office 365 tenant. So if we go to add tenant, it's asking for some information. Namely, we need a tenant ID, a client ID, and a client secret. So let's hop over to the Office 365 portal and get that set up. Here I am at the O365 portal. But you know what, before we do this, let's make sure that login is enabled. Here I am at the Office portal. I signed in to portal.office.com. And from there, I'm going to go to admin. You do need to be a global admin to do this. If you don't see the admin button there, it's
either go to all apps or just make sure that you're signed in as a global admin. I'm going to go to show all, security, and search. And under search, audit log search. Now, if you don't have audit log enabled, you'll see a button up here that indicates you need to turn it on. I do have audit logging enabled. I know that, so I don't have the button. But if you don't turn on audit logging here, you won't get any logs going to Splunk because logging won't be enabled. Okay, so that's set. Let's go back to here. I'm at portal.azure.com and I'm in Azure Active Directory. And I'm going to go to app registration. I'm going to go new registration. And I'm going to give it a name. I'll call this Splunk Logs. We'll leave the account in this organization's directory only. And under the redirect URL, it's really not important, but you do have to have something. So I'm going to put in https://localhost and register. So that creates the application, and I probably mentioned this already, but an application isn't what you would normally think of as an application like Word or Notepad. It's actually the Azure AD representation of an application that will be interacting with the directory. So it has an identity and service permissions associated with that identity. So next, I'm going to go to app permissions, and this is what's going to give this application the rights to interact with Azure AD and pull the logs. I'm going to add permission and look for Office 365 Management APIs. Go to Application Permissions. And I'm just going to select all of them. Notice there's a couple here where it's doubled. I'm not quite sure why this is, but these two are the same as well as these two. And it's going to give us an error, but it'll still work. I'm going to add permissions. So we added the permission, but we still need to grant admin consent. So I'm going to do that here. And it's going to warn me. And I'm going to click yes. Here you can see those two show an error, but it's fine. So that application now has rights to read that. So if you remember, we needed a couple pieces of information to continue. So I'm going to go up to overview. So I need this application ID and I need this directory ID. So what I can do is, I know this is blurred out for you, but there's a little copy thing here. So I'm going to copy the application ID and I'll just paste it someplace else. And I'll grab the tenant ID or the directory ID. And the other thing I needed was a secret. So just like a user account needs a username and password, basically the client ID is like the username, the directory ID or the tenant is what Azure AD tenant it's trying to pull from. And we're going to go to certificates and secrets. And I'm going to create a new client secret. I'll give it a description of Splunk. And you can set it for however long you want it. I'm just going to leave it a year. If you do have a time, just keep in mind that once that time expires, this password will no longer work. So I'm going to add. Now here's the key part to this. Once I click out of the screen, we won't be able to see this value anymore. So I'm going to copy to clipboard and I'm going to paste it someplace. If you have a password safe or password management of some sort, you might want to put it in there. You can create a new one if you lose this, but you cannot get access to this value again. Okay, so that's how you set up an application ID and give it rights to the Microsoft Office 365 Management API. So let's go back into Splunk. And I'm going to give it a name of my tenant. And I'm going to select worldwide. And it's going to ask for the tenant ID, client, and secret. So I'm going to paste those in. And add. Okay, so that did it. Now let's go to inputs. Because now that we have the tenant connected, we still have to tell it what logs to pull. So I'm going to go to add inputs. We'll do management activity. And I'm going to select my tenant name. We'll select the content type of audit Azure Active Directory, and I'm going to set it to the index of main. And we'll call this audit Azure AD. I'm going to add another. We'll do exchange. Again, going to the index of main, and I'll call it audit exchange. Go back to management activity. Let's see what else we have. I'm not going to do SharePoint or DLP. I'm not using SharePoint, so there won't be any traffic. And I'm not using DLP either, but go ahead and add them if that's in your environment. I'm going to do audit general. Add. Oops. There we go. Select index main. I'm going to go to service status. Select the tenant. And I'll do current status, same index. I'll do it again. This time historical status. And one more with service message. And add. Next, I'm going to run a query against this to see if we have any data yet. Just skip that. Okay, so this is good. It's returning some information. And I just want to point out, I did filter out user login because that was cluttering up the return. And also the team session started. That was also showing me a lot of information I didn't need, which may not even be in there in this instance because I didn't set up SharePoint logging. But what I want to show is that we do have a user login failure. So that shows we're logging Azure Active Directory login information. And also a service principal was removed, which again shows that it's not just logging user login activity, but also Azure AD management activity. Those are the two core logs important to logging for Azure AD, is the login information and the Azure AD activity. Okay, so unfortunately, that's about as deep as I can get into Splunk, but I do want to show a couple other things here. So if we go back to Splunk Enterprise, and I'm going to find more apps, I'm going to search for Microsoft 365. So here is the Microsoft 365 app for Splunk. This creates a dashboard with all the data we're collecting. So I'm going to install. It'll ask me for my username and password again. And before I move on, I want to go over and open up another page. If we go to the details for that add-on, what I want to show here, if we scroll down a little bit, there's a requirement for these three other add-ons. I'll leave a link to this in the comments. But it says that it will work, but you just won't get the full view of what it's doing. So I'm going to add these as well. So I'm going to do SAND key diagram. We'll install that one. Next is timeline. Again, I'll log in and install. And the third one is semicircle donut. And I'll install. And let's do done. We'll come back up here. Let's go back to the home page and see what we got. So here's my Microsoft 365 app for Splunk. If I go in, we should be able to see some visualizations of the data. So here we go. We've got a nice dashboard. You can see I've got some login failures. I've got some workload status. If I go to Azure AD and login activity, I'm going to switch this to the last week today. Here's got a little bit more information. You can see primary login is in the Midwest. And I've also got one in France and then one in, I forgot where that was. But anyway, that's you can use a VPN and make it look like you're logging in from all over the place. So there's other options up here, security and compliance. I really don't have much else to show on this, but I think you get the idea. This is how you both install the add-ons for both the logging as well as the visualization, as well as set up the Azure AD application that allows you to pull the logs from the Microsoft 365 Management API.
I hope this information helps you send log data from O365 and Azure to Splunk. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and click the bell icon for new content. Thanks for watching.